Hello, everybody. Thank you for tuning into my Before the Pen Spread. I just wanted to do a quick flip through of what my February budget page is going to be. And I know some of the lines aren't completely straight, but I'm still getting the hang of it as well. I posted it to my Instagram as well. Gabby Quiet Girl, if you're not following. But I wanted to go ahead and start planning for my week in my everyday planner. I have really come to love this A5 bullet journal. I got this from Michaels or Hobby Lobby, and it was like probably $6 or $7, but you can also get it from Amazon because not every Michaels and Hobby Lobby has the same thing. But I really love that there's so many pages in here, more than I actually realized, and it allows you to pretty much put everything you need to put in there. I went ahead and I marked down the days of the week, and I went through with a green pen because I knew I was going to be using some leaves throughout the spread, and I just kind of put some cursive under the actual handwritten days of the week. I opted to not put the actual days of the week on there just because how I would be decorating it, but you know, I may return to that in another Before the Pen Spread, but always stay tuned to find out. I decided to put down this first sticker, which is a beautiful peach yellow tone sticker with beautiful different tones of green. And I decided to incorporate that throughout my entire spread. But since I had so much space down for Sunday, I said, why not take advantage of that as well? And as always, I love to decorate the crease of any planner that I'm in. And it's a lot easier using it with a bullet journal than it has been for some of the other, you know, planners. But I know you can also do it with like a happy planner too. I think it's a tad bit more challenging for the Erin Condren, but I'm pretty sure it can be done. I just didn't do it when I had it. But back to the spread here. I decided to go ahead and decorate the edge of the day here. And I wanted to use this kind of rose gold foil with yellow this and that sticker. I thought it was really pretty, and I thought it actually would look really beautiful being layered on top of this huge floral sticker. Seems that the colors of the words complemented the sticker and the rest of the spread. So I really like whenever you have various stickers that come together and you can layer them and kind of make your planning a lot more rich. So I went ahead and put another full sticker there. This one doesn't have leaves, but I just thought it almost looks like it's watercolored, like you've painted it onto the page. That's what I get the vibe for these sorts of stickers. So, you know, if you guys are actually great painters out there, that's awesome. But for me, these stickers to me look so natural. It's almost like I did it myself. So I really get excited whenever I'm able to create a spread like that. And I decided here that after decorating the top by Monday and then putting down another half sticker for Saturday, I thought this was a good time to go ahead and start adding in some of the color boxes from the other Happy Planner sticker book that I decided to use to complement these stickers. I wanted to use some lime green stickers to complement the other greens with the leaves, and I also decided to use some other deeper greens as well. I went ahead and placed the stickers in a place as to not disrupt the actual decoration, but just to kind of give it a bit of functionality as well. And at the bottom there, I put a Think Dream Plan sticker down. And this is pretty much the completed Before the Pen Spread that I have here. I loved how everything turned out. And let me know what you guys think. As always, thanks for tuning in and be blessed.